long, long ago, in ancient India, King Shantanu ruled the kingdom of Hastinapur. For centuries, Hastinapur was ruled by the Kuru family of King Shantanu. King Shantanu married the river goddess Ganga, and they had a child named Bhishma. But Ganga had to go away to take care of so many people, as she was the river goddess. So she left Bhishma in the care of his father. Some years later, King Shantanu married a fisherwoman named Satyavati and had two sons, Vichitravirya and Chitrangada. When he was old enough, Vichitravirya became the king of Hastinapur. Bhishma was very nice to his brother Vichitravirya and let him be the king. King Vichitravirya had three children, as Dhritarashtra, Pandu and Vidura. Dhritarashtra, the eldest, was born blind. He could not rule the kingdom, so Pandu became the next king of Hastinapur after Vichitravirya. The third brother, Vidur, was a very smart man. As a minister, he played his brother rule the kingdom wisely. Bhishma supported the three brothers to rule the kingdom well and keep the people happy. King Pandu married Kunti and Madri. Dhritarashtra married Gandhari, who agreed to keep her eyes blindfolded in respect for her blind husband. Vidur married Parshvi. Dhritarashtra, Pandu and Vidur worked as a team with the help of Bhishma. This was good for the people of Hastinapur. After ruling the kingdom for a few years, Pandu made his brother Dhritarashtra the king. He left the kingdom and went to live in the forest with his two wives. With the blessings of the gods, Pandu and Kunti had three children. Their eldest son, Yudhishthir, was born with the blessings of the god of Dharma, means honesty. Their second son, Bhim, was born with the blessings of the wind god, Vayu. And their third son, Arjun, was born with the blessings of the lord of Devas, Indra. Madri and Pandu had twin boys, Nakul and Sahadev. They were born with the blessings of the Ashwin twins, the gods of sunrise and sunset, and also the doctors for all other gods. The five sons of Pandu were called the Pandavas. With the blessings of Sage Veda, Vyas, King Dhritarashtra and Queen Gandhari had 100 sons and one daughter. Their eldest son, Duryodhan, was a strong boy. Dhritarashtra and Gandhari had 99 other sons. Their daughter's name was Dushala. The sons of King Dhritarashtra and Queen Gandhari were called the Kauravas. From a young age, Duryodhana did not like his Pandavas' cousins. He grew up thinking that someday he would be the king of Hastinapur. It is never good to not like other people. Making friend is always better than making enemies. Duryodhana was going to learn that lesson in a few years. The Pandavas and Kauravas were called the Kuru princes, as they belonged to the Kuru family of kings. After the death of their father Pandu in the forest, the Pandavas came to Hastinapura to live with their cousins. Sage Kripa and Sage Drona became their gurus to give them the education they needed to rule the kingdom in the future. In the time, Arjuna became an excellent archer. Bhim and Duryodhana became experts in handling the mace. Yudhishthira was the wisest one and was always honest and made the right choices. The Pandavas and Kauravas did not like each other very much and were not friendly to each other. You should always be friendly with cousins. If you fight with family, it makes everyone sad. Before Kunti became the mother of Yudhishthira, Bhim and Arjuna, she had another child with the blessings of Surya, the sun god. His name was Karna. Kunti was too young to take care of Karna, and so she gave him away to charioteer Adhirath. Karna did not know that she was Kunti's son until he grew up. There was a big stadium in Hastinapur, where the Kuru princes were asked to showcase their skills they had learned from their teachers, Drona and Tripura. Karna wanted to be treated as a warrior and show his abilities in the event, but the Pandavas made fun of him for being a charioteer's son. Duryodhana was nice to Karna and crowned him the king of Anga. They became very good friends. Duryodhana made a new friend by being nice to Karna. Yudhishthira was the oldest prince and next in the line to be king, but Duryodhana wanted to be the king to make both princes happy. Dhritarashtra built a palace in the town of Varnavrat outside Hastinapur and made Yudhishthira its king. Duryodhana would be the next king of Hastinapur. Duryodhana wanted to hurt his cousins, so he asked his friend Purochana, who lived in Varnavrat, to set the palace on fire one night when the Pandavas were sleeping. Vidur came to know of this plan and told the Pandavas to escape the palace by building a tunnel. The Pandavas escaped into the forest before the palace was set on fire. Everyone else thought that the Pandavas had died in the fire. The Pandavas were able to escape the fire because they listened to the words of their uncle Vidur. Draupadi was the daughter of King Drupad of Panchal, another kingdom in ancient India. She was said to be very beautiful and many kings wanted to marry her. Draupadi's brother Drishtadyumna organized an archery contest. Whoever won the contest would get to marry Draupadi. The Pandavas were living in the forest after escaping from the burning palace. They attended the event disguised as normal villagers. Arjuna, the skilled archer, won the contest and married Draupadi. Since the Pandavas shared everything amongst each other, their mother instructed them to all marry Draupadi. So Draupadi had 5 husbands. The Pandavas were good sons of Kunti because they listened to their mother and shared everything with each other. After the Pandavas married Draupadi, they came back to Hastinapur and asked their uncle Dhritarashtra for their share of the kingdom. Duryodhana did not want to share anything. He asked his father to give the Pandavas a deserted piece of land outside the city. With the help of Maya, the architect of the gods, the Pandavas built a wonderful palace and city in that land and named it Indraprastha. Yudhishthira was crowned the king of Indraprastha and he performed a big puja called the Ashwamedha Yajna. Kings from all over the country, including his Kauravas cousins, were invited. Everyone loved the beautiful palace and city. With good friends and their hard work, Yudhishthira was able to convert a bad piece of land into a beautiful city. Duryodhana liked Indraprastha so much that he wanted to be its king. He made a plan to win Indraprastha with the help of his uncle Shakuni. They invited the Pandavas to Hastinapur to play a game of dice. In the game, Shakuni and Yudhishthira played against each other. One by one, Yudhishthira bet his possessions and lost them. Duryodhana, Shakuni and the Kauravas cheated the Pandavas in the game. They said bad things about them and insulted them. Because Yudhishthira lost the game, his brothers Draupadi and he had to go and live in the forest for 13 years. Duryodhana took over Indraprastha and became king of both Hastinapur and Indraprastha. Every game has limits. Even the wise Yudhishthira did not stop when he should have. After the painful loss in the game of dice, the Pandavas left Indraprastha for a long time in the forest. Of the 13 years, they had to spend the last in disguise. If the Kauravas found where the Pandavas were in the 13th year, they had to spend another 13 years in the forest. That would make it 26 years in the forest. The Pandavas wanted to get back to their kingdom as soon as possible. The Pandavas faced a lot of hardship in the forest, but they learned a lot of things too. They were angry with their Kauravas cousins and wanted to find with them at the end of the 13 years to take back their kingdom. Good people will learn to make the most of even bad situations. In their 13th year in the forest, the Pandavas had to stay hidden without being spotted. So they disguised themselves as unrelated common people and hide in the court of King Virat. Arjun was in disguise as a dance teacher to King Virat's daughter, Uttara. Yudhishthir became an advisor and minister to King Virat. Bhim was the cook for the king. Nakul took care of the king's horses and Sahadeva took care of the royal cows. Draupadi was a maid to Queen Sudeshna. The Pandavas managed to stay undetected by anyone until the 13th year was over. There is honor and respect in every job, even for princes. After 13 years in the forest, the Pandavas wanted their kingdom back, but Duryodhana did not want to share anything with the Pandavas. He was very selfish. Lord Krishna went on behalf of the Pandavas to convince the Kauravas that war was not good for anyone. Krishna said that a lot of people would get hurt in the war, but Duryodhana did not listen. After all, peace options failed. It was decided that war was the only way. All the kings across the country had to choose sides with the Pandavas or the Kauravas. Soon, the entire country was ready for the biggest war ever. Duryodhana didn't listen to his parents and uncles and wanted to have a war. It's always important to listen to the word of elders. The Pandavas army and the Kauravas army met for a big battle in the field of Kurukshetra. Arjuna was sad to see that he was going to fight his cousins, uncles and teachers. Lord Krishna, who had agreed to be Arjuna's charioteer, told him that he had to do it because it was his duty. Lord Krishna's lesson to Arjuna before the war is called Bhagavad Gita. Both sides fought the battle very hard. For the first few days, each side had good times and bad times. But soon after, the Pandavas started doing better than the Kauravas. Bhishma, the commander of the Kaurava army, was defeated on the 10th day, which each passing day, more and more Kaurava commanders started to lose. By the 15th day, things were starting to favor the Pandavas a lot. Although some of the kings and warriors on the Pandavas side had also suffered injuries in the battle, the Kauravas suffered much more losses. Drishtadyumna defeated Drona and soon Arjun defeated Karna. Those big victories helped the Pandavas a lot. On the 18th day, Bhim and Duryodhan fought a long and hard battle with their hands and their mace. After a long fight, Bhim won. Once the Kaurava king lost, the war was over. Victory always favors good people. The Pandavas had won the 18th day war, but they had also lost a lot of friends and family. The entire Kuru family was very sad about the war. War is never good. It is always best to resolve things by talking and not fighting. If the Pandavas and Kauravas had agreed by just talking, the war would not have taken place. Nobody would have gotten hurt. Yudhishthir was crowned the king of the entire kingdom, which included Indraprastha and Hastinapur. The Pandavas became the ruler of the country. It was a time of great joy and prosperity for all the people of Bharat. By being good, the Pandavas finally became the rulers of the Hastinapur. Good people always win.